In this video, we'll be covering how to calculate the support reactions of a simply supported beam with a point load and a uniformly distributed load, sometimes called a UDL. By the end of this video, you'll be able to determine the support reactions of a simply supported beam and use this knowledge to solve similar problems. If we look at the beam, we can see that it is 5 meters in length and has supports at either end labeled RA and RB. It has a uniformly distributed load of 80 newtons per meter applied across the whole beam. It also has a 200 newton load applied 1.5 meters from the left. As the beam is stationary, the forces acting on it must cancel out and it is said to be in equilibrium. Our goal is to find the support reactions at RA and RB. To simplify the problem, we can replace the UDL with an equivalent point load. The magnitude of the equivalent point load for a UDL like this one is equal to the area under the distribution and is located at the centre of the distribution. In this case, we have an 80 newtons per metre load applied over 5 metres. So, the equivalent point load would have a magnitude of 400 newtons and would be located at the 2.5 metre point. As we can see, our problem has now become a simply supported beam with two point loads. To determine the support reactions, we will use the method of moments. We begin by taking moments about point RA. Since the distance of the reaction force at RA is zero, the moment of RA must also be zero. Next, we'll calculate the clockwise and anticlockwise moments. Starting with the clockwise moments, we have a 200 newton load at a distance of 1.5 meters and a 400 newton load at a distance of 2.5 meters. So, total clockwise moments equal 200 times 1.5 plus 400 times 2.5. which equals 1,300 Nm. In the anticlockwise direction, the only moment we have is the support reaction RB at a distance of 5 meters. Since the beam is in equilibrium, the clockwise and anticlockwise moments must be equal, and therefore we can transpose this to find RB by dividing 1,300 by 5, which gives us 260 Newtons. We must then repeat this process by taking moments about point RB. Since the distance of the reaction force at RB is zero, the moment of RB must also be zero. Next, we'll calculate the clockwise and anticlockwise moments again. Starting with the anticlockwise moments this time, we have a 400 newton load at a distance of 2.5 meters and a 200 newton load at a distance of 3.5 meters. So, total anticlockwise moments equal 400 times 2.5 plus 200 times 3.5, which equals 1,700 Nm. In the clockwise direction, the only moment we have is the support reaction RA at a distance of 5 meters. Since the beam is in equilibrium, the clockwise moments must be equal to the anticlockwise moments, and we can again transpose this equation to find RA by dividing 1,700 by 5, which gives us 340 newtons. To check our calculation is correct, we can sum the vertical forces up and down. The sum of the upward forces, RA plus RB, is 340 plus 260, which equals 600 newtons. The sum of the forces applied in the downward direction is 200 plus 80 times 5, which equals 600 newtons. Since the sum of the upwards and downwards forces cancel out to zero, our calculation is correct. We hope you found this video helpful in understanding how to calculate the support reactions of a simply supported beam with a point load and a uniformly distributed load. Remember to break down the calculation steps into smaller parts and use visual aids to help you solve similar problems in the future. Thanks for watching. Please check the channel for similar engineering related content.